Praise the Lord, everyone. My name is Arthur Kamia Omusolo, and I serve with Scripture Union Uganda as the regional coordinator for Eastern Uganda. I'm glad once again to come to you through your gadgets where you're able to watch this from. Before we take it off, let's first pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this opportunity once again to speak King of Glory to your people. And Father, we pray that as we share your word, you'll speak to us individually. You'll speak to our souls, King of Glory, Jehovah, and that you'll surely cause healing in us and transformation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'm going to ask you to turn with me to the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 6, verses 18, and you shall go till 20. And I want to speak purely about fleeing from sexual immorality. Verse 18 says, and I'm reading from the NIV version, it says, "Flee from sexual immorality. All other sins a man or a person commits are outside the body, but whoever sins sexually sins against his own body." That's verse 18, and starts by saying, flee from sexual immorality. To flee is to run away from, to run away, not to run to. But in this generation today, people are so much running to sexual immorality instead of running from sexual immorality. When we speak of sexual immorality, many people still think of just having sex, the boy and girl, man and woman. No. Sexual immorality is any sexual act that is not right in the eyes of God. Things to do with fornication, masturbation, lesbianism, homosexuality, pornography, name them. Those are all forms of sexual immorality, and they are sinful before the Lord. They are very addictive, remember. You can start them slowly. You can start thinking, I'm just doing it for once. I'm just giving it a try. And slowly, the habit keeps on growing. It continues to grow slowly, and by slowly, before you realize it, you're addicted. And even when you get married, when you have that addiction, it will always come back to you. You'll never be satisfied by your partner. And so that's why the Bible is telling us to flee from sexual immorality. Verses 19 goes ahead and tells us that, do you not know that your bodies are the temples of the Holy Spirit? Now, if your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, yet you are committing sexual immorality against that very body, surely it seems as though you are committing sex in the temple of the Lord. You're making the temple of the Lord impure. You are making it dirty. And that is not right. We ought to treat our bodies with respect. We ought to handle ourselves as people of integrity. What is your self-worth? Are you worth going with every other person in the name of happiness? Just satisfying your body, and yet you are killing your body. That is wrong. Remember, sexual immorality, any sin committed, that one particularly is against your own body. What is your worth as a person? Are you worth a chapati? You, my fellow brother, my fellow sister, are you worth a chapati out there and they just use your body? Take care of your body. You are worth more than just that. Verses 20 will tell us that you were bought at a price. You were bought at a price. And so, honor your body by serving the Lord. Honor God with your bodies, friends. The fact that God created you and He chose you to serve Him, He did not tell you to serve Him through sexual immorality. He wants you to serve Him with your body through glorifying Him. Sing to the Lord. Perform different things for the Lord. Take up positions of leadership in church, so that you are responsible, so that even the people around you are transformed by your actions, so that the people around you are motivated. You mentor people through your actions. But if you continue indulging in sexual immorality. There is no way you're going to mentor people the right way. You are setting a wrong example for others around you. And the next time you realize you are falling sick, you're contracting diseases that you can't even treat, and you start regretting when it is too late. Please, learn to flee from sexual immorality. I know it's hard. It's very tempting. For those who have indulged in it, you say, how can I miss? How can I run away from this sweet thing? My brother, my sister, what seems sweet now may be very bitter in the future. Before you go into that act, before you go into masturbating, before you start fornicating, before you watch that blue movie, always think of yourself and your mind. What do you want for yourself in the future? Is this that you're doing going to help your future? Is it going to guide you? And even as you sit down now to watch this, ask yourself a question. As I'm watching this, what is my take point, my take home point? Am I going to continue this habit I'm in, or I'm not? We have been lockdowns and lockdowns of COVID. Our sisters have conceived. Our brothers have run away from the villages simply because they've made people go pregnant. Is that the kind of life you want to live? When we resume schools, how will you feel when your friends are going back to school and for you, you're babysitting, you're nursing a child? You are a child and you're nursing a child. Don't make your parents old at a tender age. Your parents are barely 30 and you're making them grandparents. That's not right. What goes around comes around. If you make them old, they'll also make you old one time. Friends, it's very important for us to honor the Lord, our God, with our bodies because He created us. Take time when you go to church, take up positions, find something to do in service of the Lord because He created you. Sexual immorality is no way service to the Lord. If you really feel you want to have sex, then think of marriage and marriage the rightful way. And if you know you are still young, then don't think of marriage because it is not your thing. It's not. Just give it time. Go study, work hard, make money, and the time you're marrying, it will be wow. You will enjoy it, and even the sex you have that time will be wow. Think about these words, and I pray that you'll stop sexual immorality and start serving the Lord with your bodies. I love you, and may the Lord bless you.